Very good afternoon to all my dear children. So in today's science class, we are going to learn a new chapter. So after the quarterly examinations, we have completed three lessons from seventh lesson onwards. The seventh lesson is the food habits of organisms. Eighth lesson is adaptations. And the ninth lesson is interdependence in nature. So I think and I trust you all received the thing what is there in all these lessons, right? Now in today's class we are going to learn the 10th chapter, that is natural resources. Okay children, now I request everyone to take your science book to the page number 53, and this is also an interesting lesson, very important lesson also, natural resources. Okay, so first of all, we must know what is meant by natural resources. So in Tamil, we know what is meant by natural, iyarkai. So resources means the thing, it can be material or anything, materials, anything that we are using it effectively. That is said to be resources. In Tamil, we used to say it as valangal, okay. So everyone take page number 53. Very clearly they have given, okay. So the first thing here, natural resources. Resources are things we can use, for example, money, machines and land. So resources that we are using, okay. For example, it may be money, machines or all these things that we are using. Okay. All the natural things we use are our natural resources. Okay, so all the natural things that we are using, naturally the thing that we are using, that is said to be natural resources. For example, see, air, water, soil, rocks, fuels, plants and animals are all natural resources. So air we are getting naturally, water we are getting naturally, soil, rocks, plants and animals, all these are the natural things that we are using. So all these are said to be natural resources, okay. Next, forest and grasslands, okay. Forest and grasslands. The first subtopic is forests and grasslands, okay. So forest and grassland help us in many ways. They give us wood and grasses to make paper. They give us timber, firewood and medicines. People graze farm animals on grasslands and in forest. They also collect fruits, roots, honey, bamboo and other things from them. So forest and grasslands, of course, forest and grasslands, they help us in many ways. See, we are getting wood. Okay, wood way we are getting from the tree. Like grasses to make paper, right? So the thing that we are using, paper. Then they give us timber, firewood and medicines, all the things, herbs, everything we are getting from the forest and grasslands only. Even some people, they used to graze their animals on grasslands and in forest, okay. So we are, some tribe people, they used to live in the forest. So their food, of course, definitely fruits, roots, honey, bamboo. Not like they will not get food like us. So we are getting food here, different varieties of food. But those people, those tribe people, they are getting food like fruits, roots, honey, bamboo, all the things naturally they are getting. Okay, forests and grasslands are the natural home of wild animals, of course. So we people, as we are all human beings, we are living inside a home. But where do the wild animals live? Of course, all these wild animals live in the forest and grasslands. They maintain the balance of gases in the air. Okay, they also protect the soil from erosion. Erosion in the sense being washed away. Soil erosion, you must have heard it. If there is no plants, no trees, what happens? The soil definitely during rainy season or during summer season, it might washed away. So the soil will get eroded. The roots of plants hold the soil firmly and stop it from being washed away or blown away. So what happens when the plants grows from the soil, what happens? The roots of the plants, it will hold the soil tightly, firmly, in the sense tightly, and the roots will stop being the soil washed away or blown away. Okay, and then you can see this pic they have given here. Maintain balance of gases, and here give food and shelter to animals, then protect soil, and it gives us timber, paper, firewood, honey and medicines. See how forest and grasslands help us. So how it help us, how the forest and grassland, it will maintain the gases, it gives us food and shelter to animals, and it protects the soil, and it gives us timber, paper, firewood and honey, medicines. Okay, next, wildlife. Next, wildlife. So wildlife means what? W-I-L-D, wild, L-I-F-E, life, wildlife. Wildlife means all the organisms living in their natural surroundings. So my dear children, please underline this green wordings, the sentence. See, wildlife means all the organisms. Organisms means living beings, right? All the organisms living in their natural surroundings, that is said to be wildlife. See, for example, animals living in their natural surrounding in forest. Forest is the natural surrounding of the animals. So that is said to be wildlife of the animals. So it includes all organisms living in forest, grasslands, oceans, lakes and so on. Even the animals, the organisms which lives in oceans, lakes. Okay, then some of these like fish and the other aquatic animals we eat are of use to us directly. Yes, some of these we eat, right? We use it, like fish and the other aquatic animals we eat. We are all using it directly, right? Fish and all, we used to buy from the market and we used to cook it directly and we used to eat it, right? Next, but even those that are of no use to us directly or important for maintaining the environmental, some of the organisms we are using it directly, the rest of the things that we are not using it directly, those things are to maintain the balance of the environment. Why are they? Those things are to maintain the balance in the environment. Okay, children, I think so you all understood. Now let us take page number 54. Page number 54. So we are going to read. Okay, so in page number 54, what animal is this? Of course, the tiger. So tiger is an endangered animal. Endangered in the sense, in Tamil we used to say அழிந்து கொண்டே வருகிறது. So tiger is an endangered animal. So let's read about it. You have learnt that all organisms are linked together. When even one organism vanishes from an area, the survival of many other organisms gets affected. Yes, in the previous lesson only we learnt interdependence, that is linking of animal one to another, right? If one organism vanishes, that is if one organism vanishes, destroyed from an area, what happens? The survival, the animals which depend on that organism definitely will get affected, right? Next, this upsets the environmental balance. Of course, it will affect the environmental balance. And since we too are connected to everything in the environment, it affects us. And we, even as we are all human beings, we too connected to all those organisms, and even we get affected. So next, for example, say we kill all the tigers in a forest. The deer in that forest may multiply very fast. They may eat up all the plants, and a time may come when the forest vanishes and the soil gets eroded and the place becomes a desert. So a perfect example they have given. So we used to get fear for tigers, right? If we kill all the tigers, what happens? The deer will multiply very fastly. So the tiger will eat the deer, right? If there is no tigers at all, what happens? The deer will multiply very fast, and as deer is a herbivore animal, it will eat up all the plants, and there will be no plants, no trees, and what happens? The soil only hold the root of the plant only hold the soil firmly. If there is no plants and trees, what happens? The soil will get eroded, and the place will become as a desert. Okay, next. When an organism vanishes from a place or from the world, we say that it has become extinct. Underline this word, extinct. Extinct means when an organism destroys from this world, vanishes from this world. Okay, from a place or from this world, what happens? We say that it has become extinct. So when it is getting, when it's getting slowly destroys, what happened? We used to say it as endangered. The cheetah, for example, is no longer found in India. Oh, see, in India there is no cheetah at all. From a place it's been vanished. So it is said to be extinct. So we say that the cheetah is extinct in India. So in India there is no cheetah at all, even one cheetah. So it is extinct in India. When a very few of particular kind of organism are left in a place or in the world, we say that it is endangered. Of course, for example, if an organism, only few, if an organism in a particular place it is there, only few are there, we used to say it is endangered. The tiger is endangered in India and in the world. See, tiger, for example, it is endangered in India and in the world also. Endangered organisms can become extinct soon if we do not protect them. Of course, if we are not protecting the endangered animals properly, definitely it will become extinct. It will vanish fully. Okay, so next, rocks. Okay, rocks are of three basic types. So underline this. Rocks are of three basic types. How many basic types? Three. What are they? Igneous. First one, IG, Ig, NE, NE, OUS, US, igneous. Next, metamorphic, META, meta, morphic, 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 metamorphic, and sedimentary, SEDI, sedi, MAN, TARY, teri, sedimentary, igneous, metamorphic, and sedimentary. See, igneous rocks are the oldest rocks. So underline this. Rocks are of basically three types, that are igneous, metamorphic, and sedimentary. So which one is the oldest rocks? Of course, igneous rocks. They formed when the top layer of the molten earth cooled millions of years. How it is formed? They formed when the top layer of the earth, when it starts molting, so millions of our ago. So before millions of years ago, it becomes cool and it forms igneous rocks. To ignite, that means to set fire to something. Ignite means to fire something. Underline this. So igneous means something connected with fire, of course. To ignite means to set a fire. So igneous means something it is related to fire. Igneous rocks get their name from the way they were formed, by the hardening of hot, fiery material. So igneous rocks, how they got their name? The way how it hardened through fire, okay? Some igneous rocks formed later when the lava from volcanoes cooled down. So some igneous rock, how it formed? When the lava, have you seen from the volcano, Erimalai? So when the volcano burst up, what happens? The lava will come out of it, right? So when it starts cool down, the lava, it forms igneous. Granite is an igneous rock we use as building material. See, for example, granite is an igneous rock we use as building material. Here they have given. Granite is an igneous rock, sedimentary rock. Slate is a metamorphic rock. Okay, children, I think so you have understood page number 53 and 54. So the next two things, rest of the things, we'll see in the next class. Thank you, children.